It worked!
It's your spirit gun.
My what?
A human being, as I've explained before, emits both body and spirit energy. While a ghost, you became more aware of your spirit energy and can channel it into your finger, hence the spirit gun. It's far more powerful than a normal punch, but until you increase your spirit muscles, so to speak, you can only use it once a day.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another anime review. Today, I will be reviewing Yu Yu Hakusho Season 1, The Spirit Detective Arc. So let's get on to the review. Yu Yu Hakusho revolves around a young teenager named Yusuke, who is the type of teenager who hates authority, constantly skips school, thinks he knows better than the teachers, and gets into fights very often. As a matter of fact, he is deemed to be the toughest boy in his school, and it really shows since he's able to beat up anyone who crosses his path. The story opens off with Yusuke getting killed. Yep, that's right. The protagonist dies in the very first episode for those who haven't seen the show. Yusuke recollects prior events in his head, so that way we get a general understanding about who he is and how he ended up in his current predicament. Botan is introduced as the Grim Reaper, who has a quirky and optimistic personality. She tells Yusuke that he can be revived if he passes a trial. But it's not so simple. This is where Kuwabara, Keiko, and Kuenma are introduced and have their characters established. Kuwabara has a tough guy attitude, but also a loyalty to his friends and a sensitive side. Keiko is a generic Mary Sue who is always getting after Yusuke for being a delinquent. Kuenma is the son of King Enma who gives Yusuke his trial. Yu Yu Hakusho is a shonen anime, and you wouldn't be able to tell based on the first 5 episodes. What I really like about the first 5 episodes is how it establishes the world they live in, how it is similar to ours, and the way it eases people into the whole plot of the show, which is about fighting demons. After Yusuke gets revived, he gets new powers from his time being dead, such as being able to see demons who are in disguise as humans. After defeating a demon, Botan appears again in the story and gives Yusuke the job as spirit detective and his very first mission. Being spirit detective involves fighting dangerous demons who threaten the balance between Earth, spirit world, and demon world. The first mission serves as Yusuke learning the ropes of being a spirit detective and marks the first time he faces off against opponents he can't just womp in a punch or two like his classmates. This is when we get introduced to Kurama and Hiei, who will eventually become a permanent part of the series. After the Artifacts of Darkness saga, Yusuke is put on a mission to win a mini tournament set up by an old psychic in order to receive her training. The thing is, there is an evil demon named Rando who wishes to receive the training for his own evil purposes. Kuwabara is also involved in this arc, and he also gets fully integrated into the story from here on out. Here, we get a more full-on demonstration of what Yusuke and Kuwabara can do, as well as a general understanding of how many character moments will play out between the two friends. The tournament is fast-paced, lasting only 4 episodes, but it feels like just the right pace with it being very easy to be engaged with each episode. The Saint Beast Saga is a saga with a simple plot. Defeat 4 demons in order to save the city which Yusuke lives in from people being possessed by demon parasites. This is the point where the Yusuke, Kuwabara, Kurama, and Hiei group is formed, and each one gets a chance to shine in this saga. And this is one of the things I love about Yu Yu Hakusho's character utilization aspect. After the Saint Beast Saga, Yusuke, Kuwabara, and Botan head to rescue a young girl who is part of an ice clan. Yusuke and Kuwabara display how strong they have gotten by easily dealing with every demon the young girl's kidnapper throws at him. But just when we thought they were going to continue dominating everything, the first major villain of the series is introduced, Tagoro. And Tagoro is a very intimidating villain. He looks like an even more beefed up young Arnold Schwarzenegger, From his first punch, you know his raw strength is a force to be reckoned with, especially since he says he is using such a low percentage of power during this arc. After the arc is over, Tagoro gives Yusuke an ultimatum: participate in a tournament full of demons, or Tagoro kills Yusuke and everyone he knows and loves. A lot of people underrate Season 1 because of how many mini storylines are in it, but I really enjoy this portion of the story. The episodes are fast-paced, and you get a general insight of the plot and the characters of the show. If you haven't seen the show yet, I highly recommend it, especially if you like shonen anime like Dragon Ball. If you are a Hunter x Hunter fan, I'm sure you have heard it 1,000 times, but I'm going to be the 1,001th time. But you need to watch Yu Yu Hakusho if you haven't seen it yet. It is classic Togashi, it has great characters along with really great character moments and development, really good fights, hilarious comedy sprinkled in here and there. Yu Yu Hakusho still remains as one of my all-time favorite anime. The Dark Tournament is the next on my list for review. Join me next time for that. And until next time, thank you for watching, and have a great day, everyone.